Natasha Ryan. The girl who made everyone in Australia live in fear for 5 years, Natasha was born during mid-1984 in Rockhampton Town in Australia. Natasha used to live with her mother Jenny and her father Robert, and her older sister Donna, and younger brother Chris. During her childhood, everything was totally normal, except that her parents got divorced at some point, which in fact affected Natasha's state of mind for a while. Years passed by, and on 1998, she fell in love with a guy named Scott Black, which was pretty weird because Scott was 21 years old while Natasha was only 14 at that time. Natasha's mom was not okay with this relationship, so the usual routine between Natasha and her mom was daily fights over everything Natasha does, especially that she started smoking drugs at that time, which is totally unacceptable in general, and unacceptable in specific for a girl of 14 years old. As a result of these fights, Natasha decided to run away from her home few times with the help of her boyfriend Scott Black, but she never stayed more than a day or two out of her home. Within few months, on the 31st of August 1998, her mother dropped her at school like every day, but nothing went normally after that point. Natasha did not come back home after school. Even the school principal said that Natasha did not attend any classes that day. Her mother Jenny went to the police station right away, but they didn't take her case seriously as Natasha already ran away from home few times, so they advised her to wait for 48 hours before they start taking any practical action. So her mother waited, as suggested, but Natasha was still missing even after the 2 days have passed. Since that day, the police started working around the clock on Natasha's case. Later on, the investigation showed that the last time someone saw Natasha was in front of the town theater with an old man, but nobody knew his identity. The police had to question everything around her, so from their perspective, everyone was a suspect, including her parents, her brother and sister, her best friend, Myoha, and of course her boyfriend Scott, as he already helped her in similar situations of running away. But when Scott was faced with questions, he swore that he has nothing to do with her case at all. He admitted that he already helped her in escaping home few times, but this time he is not involved in such thing. Months went by, and Natasha is still missing. Her mother was showing up on TV, saying that Natasha is indeed kidnapped, and that she will never run away and cause such pain for the whole family. She is indeed kidnapped. By the beginning of the next year, many girls gone missing in a very short time, which was alarming to the whole town, as this was sort of a confirmation that there's a kidnapper in town. Natasha was the first to be missing, following her a girl of 39 years old named Julie Turner. After her, there was a girl that disappeared named Beverly Lego. Beverly was 36 years old when she gone missing, and during the April 1999, the fourth girl was kidnapped. Her name was Kara, and she was just 9 years old when she gone missing, and this time Kara was the key for the police to solve the whole case. What happened was that Kara was walking home by herself and decided to take a shortcut this time, but when she was walking, someone suddenly hit her on the head. Then he lifted her up and laid her in the trunk of his car and went away. One of the neighbors saw the whole scene, and therefore he called the police and told them everything. And with little bit more digging, the police found out that the man who kidnapped Kara was wearing a yellow shorts and a white shirt. And when they got some details from the witness about how the man looked like, they started questioning the whole neighborhood and finally concluded that the man they're searching for is someone called Leonard John Freezer. And later on, it appeared to be that Leonard is known to the police, as he has previous cases of hitting women and was actually in jail for over 20 years before. After the police broke into Leonard's home and after checking his car, they found traces of Kara's blood in his car trunk and on a white shirt in his closet. But unfortunately, they didn't find Kara, so he was accused of kidnapping Kara, not the other girls so far. After a few days, the police got a report of a missing girl called Sylvia of 19 years old, and she appeared to be one of the relatives of Leonard. After that incident, they made more deep investigations to connect the dots, and they found out that every girl of them had something to do with Leonard. For example, they found out that Julie and Leonard were co-workers, and Beverly was a neighbor of Leonard. Also, Natasha's mom said that she saw Leonard a lot at the same bowling club Natasha used to go to every weekend. More strangely, some people said they saw Leonard and Natasha together. Now every clue is pointing at Leonard, so the police started to put more attention to Leonard and started to investigate with his fiancée. And weirdly enough, She told them that the day Natasha disappeared, Leonard was out for whole 2 hours. And when he came back, he was wearing something different than what he was out with. And then they went out, and while they were passing beside the forest, he stopped suddenly and told her to wait in the car. Then he grabbed a kid's doll from the back seat and walked inside the woods. After a few minutes, he came back but without the doll. And after that, he threatened her to never tell a word of what she saw. After the police heard what his fiancée have said, they arrested him right away, and when he confessed and told them the exact place he went to in the woods, they went out right away, and unfortunately they found Kara, but she was dead by that time. They were late, but that's not the end of this case. After Leonard trials, he was sentenced 25 years of jail, and while Leonard was in jail, he proudly told his cell inmate that Kara is not the only girl he had killed, and that there was many girls before her. And in the next day, his inmate went directly to the head officer of the prison and told him what he knew. The investigation from this point was opened again, and with his extra confessions, he gave more details about his crimes, in which Natasha's appeared to be one of his victims. He actually confessed that Natasha was one of his victims, and that she was even pregnant from him. The police at this point tried to make a deal with him in order to know the exact places where he buried the dead girls' bodies. The deal was that he'll be imprisoned in a special cell with dedicated guards for him in order to avoid any prison violence, as he was sentenced for life, and that was a great opportunity for him to leverage his jail time quality. So he accepted the deal and told them where he buried the girls, except Natasha's body. He didn't want to tell any detail about her or where he buried her body. And in the next trial, the judge said that Leonard was innocent of killing Natasha. Here, nobody knew what was going on, why the judge said that. But the funny thing is, Natasha was alive indeed. On April 10, 2003, the police received an unknown call telling them that Natasha's boyfriend Scott Black is keeping her in his house. When the police arrived, they noticed that Scott was anxious and overstressed. And while the police was searching up his home, they found a girl in his wardrobe. And yes, what you are thinking of is correct. That girl was Natasha. The police called up her mother to let her know that they found her daughter. And when they all went to the station, Natasha said that she was at Scott's house by her will, and that Scott had nothing to do with her case at all, and she is the one responsible for the whole thing. She also refused to tell the reason that made her run away from her home at the first place. And when she stood up against the judge in one of Leonard trials after that, she said that she does not know him, and that she even never saw him before, which is weird because some witnesses said they saw them together, and Leonard confessed that he killed her. But at the end, it all appeared to be false. The witnesses were not right about what they saw, and Leonard never saw Natasha, but he said that just to brag like any psychopath would do in such a situation, where he was already sentenced for life in jail. After that, Scott was sentenced 3 years in jail for misleading the police, but ended up with spending only 12 months in jail. And after a few years, Natasha and Scott got married, and her family relationship got much better, especially with her mother. And that was the case that turned Australia upside down during late 90s. What do you think? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to support my episodes. Thanks for watching, until next time.